for the SD Lee grant because it's sometimes hard to carve out the time to really try something new. And this seemed like a way to really invest in something that we knew we wanted to invest in and put some resources behind doing that experimentation. Teaching with special collections at Harvard is kind of an amazing opportunity. And for the students, there's really nothing like it. They get to be hands-on with this stuff. And we have really active teaching programs, not just at Houghton, but all over the university. The students are working with primary sources so that they're in there, they're seeing it, they're learning about how to do that research, how to generate new knowledge. And I think with this grant, one of the things that we wanted to kind of put out there was just that there's more than that. That there are ways of layering this kind of work, ways of building really radically different skill sets for students. So what we wanted to do was really think about the way that we can bring some of the newer computational humanities, digital humanities work into our specialization with primary source exploration and engagement to show just how much can really be done, can really be accomplished by working with the library.
The need that the grant fulfills is it allows us to complete this project on a faster timeline. It's 60,000 slides, so it's a big project, a multi-year project. But it also allows us to give the collection greater exposure sooner than we otherwise would by allowing non-experts and experts alike to contribute to the platform that we'll use. We'll be gaining input in the form of subject tags and data that we can apply to the images we're publishing.
We're going to be learning from the users of the metadata games, as well as hopefully teaching them something, because we'll see how an expert tags the images and how a non-experienced person tags them. We'd like to look forward to using this model as something that we can build upon, meaning that we'd like to be able to do other crowdsourcing projects to get more of our images cataloged, particularly the difficult ones. And that was the impetus for this, was to really be able to catalog things that we don't have necessarily a lot of information on, but we have received the images.
Especially working in special collections, what we don't want to have happen is to have, you know, these incredible images and pieces of art that we work on to be siloed off. So I think just opening it up and bringing these works into the light through the ST Lee grant, I think that's the best possible work that the grant can do.
Project that I've been working on for the past year is the Harvard Law School Community Capture Project. And that project originally set out to prototype a file transfer tool to help student organizations on the HLS campus transfer files from whatever space they're using, Google Drive or shared folders, to special collections to be preserved. I think one of the things that's been most surprising and rewarding to me is the collaborative work that's actually gone into this project. This project allowed us to hire someone to work part-time and really dedicate their time to reaching out to students doing a lot of outreach work. And I also worked with another staff member at HLS, and being able to sit in the room, just the three of us, and kind of work through ideas and problems and let ourselves go off on tangents has been like really helpful and also a lot of fun. Definitely working with other people has been the part that I've enjoyed. I hope that we're able to continue this work. I hope that it just becomes part of our ongoing collections work that we do in historical and special collections. And I think that that's mostly possible. I mean, it definitely is gonna take a lot of staff time and energy, but having this year with some extra help to really think through the processes has given us a good sense of what we need to do kind of next academic year, next time around. So I think that we can do it a little bit more efficiently, and it won't be so daunting to add new work into our ongoing stuff.
I submitted a grant to do service design in libraries, and specifically journey maps. And I propose that we follow LLM students from their first day here through graduation and look at what kind of data we get from that to inform different services and products at the library. The LLM population at the law school, I thought, was a good set of students to try this on, since they're here for a discrete amount of time. They're here for 1 year. And so being able to measure that experience for one full year, I thought would be useful. It's interesting to see how students' perceptions and interactions with the library change over time. Looking at things a way that we hadn't looked at things before, which is across a journey. There's so many different services in the library, and it's easy for departments to work in discrete functional silos, rather than looking at this from a faculty's point of view or a student's point of view, and how when they're on a journey to write a paper or teach a course, they experience multiple services, but they experience it all as one journey. So just trying to change it to kind of have a bird's eye view of that experience, I think is really helpful for the staff.
Essentially, we want to provide end users with a single place they can go if they're looking for digital-only material and get result sets that they can actually get to all of the content online immediately. The inspiration was to test what the value of having a single point of access to all digital material at the library would be like. Say we want to present something as simple as title for each digital object. It appears in a different location because it's a different metadata standard in the image catalog, the EAD finding aids catalog, the MARC record bibliographic catalog. And so we're going to harvest all of the metadata from the different source catalogs, transform it to a common format so that then we can use APIs for our own consumption of that metadata or to provide to others. I think many people are going to be surprised at the depth and breadth and riches of the digital content we have in special collections and archives that are not easily surfaced amidst all of the other content that we have in the catalogs.
We have put into place a very mobile desk that is also, I like to think of it as much less of a barrier than a traditional public service desk. One of the biggest surprises has been a variety of patrons coming up and offering spontaneously the information that it's wonderful to have you out here. We were aware of a need, and thank the stars, the ST Lee program and the grant was able to make it a reality for a pilot. We are employing a lot of different assessment methods, including a survey, observations, debriefing staff. The whole purpose is to assess the pilot. Are people finding it? Are people willing to approach it? It may seem like a no-brainer, but this is something that a number of us have wanted for a very long time. Frankly, I've wanted it for 23 plus years. I want to make sure that everyone knows this was a huge team effort. I and a number of my colleagues are just so happy.
There's a lot to harness, and sometimes grants give us that chance to make room for something new and to try something and to let it work really well and then see how we can build it into something that has sustainability.
I think one of the things to keep in mind is that there's actually some room for failure of a certain kind in this project.
Take a risk, try it. If it doesn't work, try something else.
It's a great way to collaborate with others at the university, throughout other libraries, in the technical realm, to try to accomplish something at the libraries that isn't part of our daily business.
The mere opportunity to try it is huge. And to me, that is the real substance that the STE grants offer.